So I've come to a customer's property today. They're having a bathroom renovation, as you can see. We're here to do the electrical work, so we're here to put in downlighters, and we're here to do the extraction unit. As you can probably see by the light there, second fix now. So I thought it was a good opportunity really for a video to sort of discuss what we have to take into consideration as electricians in a bathroom or a special location as such. So we're going to look at the zones. So zone 0, zone 1 and zone 2. What sort of equipment we can fit in them zones and the measurements that them zones take up. So first of all, we come to zone 0, okay? The danger zone as such. So zone 0 in this instance here is actually all of this area inside of the bath, okay? So up to the edge of this bath, anywhere there is zone 0. Now, generally in a domestic dwelling, we're not really going to be fitting anything inside zone 0. We may get that in swimming pools, etc. We would need to look in BS 7671 for the regulations to go with that. But according to the on-site guide, if we was to install in zone 0, okay, it must be a minimum IP rating of IPX7. Okay, and it must either be 12 volts AC maximum or 30 volts DC. Now, as you notice, there's no bath panel here, okay? So at the minute, this would be classed as zone 1 in a bathroom, okay? Because there's no bath panel here. If we did put a bath panel here, it wasn't accessible without the use of a tool, okay? It would still be classed as zone 1. However, if it was a bath panel that you would require a tool to get into, we would then class this as outside of the zones, okay? So remember, zone 0 here, under the bathtub, if we can get to it without the use of a tool, it's zone 1, and we'll talk about zone 1 and where that extends to it as well in a minute. However, if we have a panel here that we need a tool to access, then this would be classed as outside of the zones. Therefore, we may be able to install whirlpool motors, etc. So carrying on from what we were talking about regarding zone 1 under the bathtub, we're now going to look at where zone 1 actually extends to in this area. Okay, so zone 1 actually extends from the floor to 2.25 meters, okay, on the edge of zone 0. So zone 0 being in the bath, so from the edge of this bath, from the floor, 2.25 meters high, okay? And that will be classed as zone 1. So if we look, the ceiling is actually around 2.65 meters. So anything above 2.25 meters in this scenario would be classed as outside of the zones, and below 2.25 meters will be classed as zone 1. Now, if I had like a shower and a waterfall head, okay, then zone 1 could extend to above that. If that was above 2.25 meters, we would actually extend zone 1 past that waterfall or fixed shower outlet. And some of the accessories we would actually install, okay, or pieces of equipment we'd install in zone 1 would potentially be showers, etc. They must all have a minimum IP rating of at least IPX4, or if there's water jets present, they must be IPX5. Now, you get a lot of conversation saying, well, electric showers, they're water jets. There's not many electric showers I've installed that I would class as jets of water. Okay, they normally just trickle onto your head, okay? So still IPX4, and that would be the minimum requirement of installing anything like that in zone 1 of a bathroom. So now we've talked about zone 1, we're going to look at zone 2 now. This is the last zone as such. So zone 2 actually extends from zone 1 by 600 millimeters, okay? So if zone 1 being the edge of the bath, 2.25 meters high, I would measure 600 millimeters, and that would be the edge of zone 2, okay? Now, accessories, etc., I can go in zone 2. Again, is IPX4, the same as zone 1, IPX5 if jets of water are present. But general rules apply with this according to the on-site guide. So this would be 600 mil this side, 600 mil the other side, and it extends the full length as such, or height of zone 1. So 600 mil all the way around. So now we've sort of explored the zones, okay, and we understand the measurements of the zones. Now we can maybe talk about some other little aspects of it. So again, 30 milliamp protection, additional protection via an RCD is generally needed now where a circuit is supplying or running through the zone of a special location. Okay, it's generally something we've moved towards now with all circuits being RCD protected, especially in a domestic dwelling. However, there is still the use of supplementary bonding in some properties, and we'll go into that in another video. Also, it's important to know that from the edge of zone 1, okay, a socket outlet can now be mounted. This is a change in amendment 2, can now be located 2.5 meters. Okay, it used to be 3 meters. They've now decided that it can now be 2.5 meters. So really, now we've looked at the zones for a bathtub. Okay, so zone 0, zone 1, and zone 2. There are other aspects that we need to take account to. If we maybe don't have a bathtub, we'll look at them in later videos, such as shower trays, airing cupboards, what they sort of do to the zones inside a bathroom. In this bathroom, we've actually installed IP65 downlights. It's technically outside of the zones. However, the downlights we've installed have been IP65. So just remember, the equipment you're going to be installing in bathrooms generally is going to have some sort of IP rating. And remember, that second letter or numeral is in relation to the ingress of moisture. As always,
we hope this video has been some help.